Mr. Harden came last time, and there were a series of questions that were asked by the audience, and I did prepare some answers to those questions, because I did want to follow up with some of the questions that were asked, and we'll touch on some of those points as well. And then I'll sort of conclude and then take any questions, okay? There was a question about programs that are basic and are being done at other schools, and that West Charlotte needs to be more drastic to address problems or something innovative. And what I'm currently doing with my staff, I have typical faculty meetings once a month. If anybody's been in the school system or a teacher or a member of a school faculty, typically once a month you have a faculty meeting, and the principal disseminates information, goes over compliance issues, talks about the rules and regulations of what you have to follow as a school. Well, I do that usually through my weekly bulletin, all the compliance things. The Wednesday meetings are designed to get input from faculty around the big rocks that I see in school. And some of part of the innovative work that's being done is being done by the faculty. And the four big rocks are this: student attendance, student behavior, student achievement, and how do we look at West Charlotte and provide the brand or the marketing of West Charlotte that's positive in the community? Because I think we often deal with not getting the good news out. All you hear is about the negative, and I'll be honest with you, there are more good things happening in West Charlotte than negative, but that story sometimes doesn't get told. So part of that is going to be the conversation that the faculty is having. And we repurpose time during faculty meetings to go over that information, to talk about those things, because it's real simple. If you can get kids to come to school, you get them to behave themselves, their student achievement will go up and they will graduate from high school. It's that simple. Getting that done is difficult. So we've got a lot of different things that we have in place and we're looking at. We've got a lot of partnerships with mentoring programs. I think last time, Mr. Harden, you shared about the Global Mental Care, Y Achievers, Project Cares. You have a lot of organizations, Charlotte's Web, a lot of organizations that are working with students to case manage them, to provide them exposure to opportunity. And I think that's key too. So when I look at how do we change a child's trajectory? Well, it was a 10th grade teacher who changed mine. My parents knew I was gonna go to college, but I'm a first time college attendee. They hadn't been to college. But I had a 10th grade teacher who showed me the West. You know, he gave me the input on what I needed to concentrate on. Same thing happens in 2013. We have to expose kids to those opportunities that they're not aware of. So we're doing a lot of that. We're looking at, for next year, from some innovative ways of looking at an alternative learning center at West Charlotte for kids who are struggling that might need more assistance. We're also looking at night school as a potential option for some kids who might need additional assistance as well. So that's all a budget funding kind of thing to be able to make sure that we're able to pull that off. I'm not saying that's going to happen next year, but we're looking at those opportunities. I think it takes a community school model where we open up West Charlotte to the community to try to solve some of the issues that kids have and families have. That's another conversation that's happening globally. That's also a funding and sort of an agency aligning themselves properly with West Charlotte and the needs that are there. Another question that came up was, how are we addressing the social, emotional, or economic issues of the students at West Charlotte? All of those mentoring programs I just shared. Then our counselors have groups and things that they work with at Promise students. People tend to say at risk, I tend to say at Promise. And they work with at Promise students around those deficits that they have in order to be able to help them overcome. We're also looking at a partnership with Central Piedmont Community College. I went over and met with them just a couple of weeks ago, and they're looking at a dual enrollment program for students who have the aptitude and the work ethic, because you have to have both, to be able to earn college credit while in high school. That is huge to me. And if you have been over to Central Piedmont Community College, there's a lot of opportunities for kids who are not going to go to college. Because if you look at the information out there, everyone's not going to go. But if they can get a skill, they can get something that's going to engage them economically, they're going to be more successful as they become older adults, because that's the goal, of giving them that skill. But I saw a lot of good things over the HVAC program. And he talked to me about a kid from West Charlotte who graduated from West Charlotte, went to see PCC, did not finish the certification, dropped out after 1 year, coming back though, and he earned $60,000 to $70,000 in the HVAC field because he had the work ethic to go out and get a job to do what he had to do, and he's going to come back and finish the certification. But it's those kind of things, welding opportunities, technical and engineering opportunities for kids, and there are jobs that are coming in the future that are huge as long as you have the skill set. There are actually jobs that kids are not filling because they don't have the skill set. And I think that's going to be a good connection for West Charlotte to be able to do that. So that's some of the ways that we're going to try to address the economic opportunities for kids and those partnerships that are out there. There was a question about more programs on youth development needed. Again, all of those mentoring programs are built around that. But Mr. Harden, my assistant principal and a group of others at the school, we're really looking at a black male initiative. And I know when you look at the subgroup performance, black males tend to struggle the mightiest. And in that initiative, we're looking to empower them to learn manhood skills. That is going to be something that is going to be outside of the school day, of course, but to empower them to learn how to become men. Because at the end of the day, that's what we're trying to build. We're not just trying to build students who graduate, we want to build men and women to be successful when they graduate from West Charlotte. And there's a particular set of skills you need to have to be able to do that. So that's going to be something we're looking at from an innovative way. In addition, is anybody familiar with the Search Institute work around 40 developmental assets? Okay. There, if you have an opportunity to Google, you look at the Search Institute, there's information about what kids need to be successful in life. There's 40 attributes. If you're missing five, you tend to be a high school dropout. If you're missing 10, you tend to end up in prison. That's how serious that research is. So looking at those 40 developmental assets, if we can put as many of those things in place for kids, we can solve some of the problems before that happens. But again, it's being proactive, being forward-thinking, and making sure that we have those things in place. Everything's not going to get done this year. It's a five-year plan. All those components are being built as we speak by the current staff. There was a question about engaging parents. Mr. Harden, along with other members of my team, we have a parent advocate, Ms. Nicholson, who's not here today. But we're looking at having parent summits and bringing parents to the back to West Charlotte, engaging them and advocating for their children, providing them the opportunity to work with us and partner with us to ensure that their children are successful at West Charlotte. And she's also working with our team to do parent outreach. That's sometimes heavy lifting, getting parents to come, I'll just be honest with you. So we might have to go to them. That takes a matter of planning that work as well. Because again, there's no excuses. We got to do what we have to do to get it done. There was a question about the NCCU alumni, and Brian McCorkle's not here. But if anybody's here from the NCCU, I plan on. A good deal. I'm an Eagle too. He's an Eagle too. I'm not sure if there are other Eagles in here.
We're also giving out scholarships to scholarships.
Gotcha. I plan on coming in March. So
you can
get
the
image.
All right.
I just want to meet you.
Yes. All right. Thank you. So I plan on attending that in the March meeting. And I'll get with those folks to discuss that. There was a question about fatherless homes, and is that relevant to the discussion? It is relevant, but it's outside of my sphere of influence. So what I try to do, to be honest with you, I have a message of let's rise above the circumstance, whatever it might be. And you know, we all have stories in our families of people who have, you know, made it despite the circumstances. So that's sort of my message, because I'm in the hope business as a principal. That's what I do. I bring hope, and I try to bring kids to the understanding that there is hope and there is success. If you do this and you do this and you do this, you give them a blueprint. So it is relevant, but again, I can't control that particular part of the students' lives. Focus on African-American students to assist with school issues, and what are you bringing to West Charlotte to make change? The key, and that's the last two questions, and then I'll sort of turn it over to you guys and answer any questions that you have. The key to changing a school environment is not necessarily buy-in. Buy-in comes from success. So what we have to do is look at the data. We have to look and see where kids are struggling. What are we going to do different to impact the change for kids? And it's all around looking at the numbers consistently throughout the year, so that at the end of the year, we're not surprised by what we find. That is very difficult to do, but it's something that I'm bringing, data-driven instruction, professional learning communities where teachers are looking at how kids are performing weekly, a conversation around progress monitoring, how kids are performing in class, so that we're not surprised how they perform on the EOC or how they perform on the ACT, which is a college readiness exam, or whatever particular standardized test that they need to take. And as we see success, like if the graduation rate jumps to 68% or over to 75%, people will start looking at what are they doing at West Charlotte? What are they doing to make that happen? It's all around looking at the kids individually and meeting them where they are. And that really ties in hand with what Superintendent Morrison is doing at this at the system level with his Way Forward plan. My plan is not exactly that way because it's more about governance and some other things. But if you look at it, it's sort of a mini plan towards trying to achieve what he's trying to achieve. So at the end of the day, that's what I'm trying to bring to West Charlotte as far as change and hope and direction and belief and all the other things that are necessary to help kids be successful. What I do need from the community is your help. And Mr. Harden touched on this, and I won't go into detail about it, but I'll give us five programs. It's real simple. Five positive comments about West Charlotte, every place you go, okay? Five community contacts that can help West Charlotte, or five business contacts. Five donations to the school, whether it's, you know, white paper, whatever you can give to the school. You'd be surprised how excited teachers get when they get a ream of paper, because I'm telling you, the resources sometimes are not there. You also can help out with five volunteer hours. Dr. Daisy Walker, many of you are probably familiar with that name. She's waiting to take your name and put you to work at West Charlotte. And then finally, you can give $5 to the graduating class of your choice. So after 4 years, say if you give to ninth grade for the next 5 years, or next 4 years, then at the end of that 4 years, you'll have $15,000 in the bank to give a gift back to West Charlotte and then that graduating class. So everything you give will go back to the school as some sort of major gift, okay? So I would ask for your support in that way. If you can do all five, great. If you can do one of the five, great. But that is something that I will continue to promote as a principal of West Charlotte.